It's pretty expensive. Not cheap, but I think what the success, the advertisement, the publicity that we give James out, that we give,
that Ellie does,
you know, people out there, it's a lot of pluses, because I get a lot of sponsors who will give me money, which is, you know, check it out, Ellie. Come
on. Oh, wow.
I get a lot of sponsors. People like Josh Valdez, who is another sponsor over there. Falcon guy, El Dorado, Rainmaster.
That's right.
And Everlast, who has basically given me most of the boxing equipment, like bags, speed bags, canvas, corners, everything in the gym. So Everlast has done a great job. So I think that's a lot of help.
The quick is a pro.
I know, that's how I'm talking about.
Boxing
Everlast, so they're big.
Boxing junkies. What fighter would you like to train that you currently don't train? I know the answer.
That I would like to train? Chavez Jr. I would love to train Chavez Jr. I know he could beat Martinez. That's why, because I know he could beat Martinez. I'll even tell him, if you don't win, you don't pay me.
Wow.
I'll even tell him that. I swear to God I won't. But don't tell him that.
Fernando Becerra, keep up the good work. I haven't heard about Alfonso Blanco, whatever happened to him.
Oh, Alfonso went back home to Venezuela. He's got homesick and took some time off. He's young. He'll come back whenever he's ready.
Jacob Setzer Conde, hey, would you be interested in helping organize a fundraiser for St. Jude's Children's Hospital?
100%.
I want to team up with Boxing Kmart.
100%. Let's do it. We got all the fighters to bring a lot of people in. We could do Maidana, Pavlik, they'll probably be training at the same time. Brandon, Tyson Marquez, Mikey will definitely show up. Hopefully by then, Chavez is here. I don't know. No, definitely. Hell yeah.
What's the number at the gym? Tell them to call you here.
What's the number here? I don't even know my number. Hold on. I don't even know my cell number, so shut up.
No, not the cell. The gym.
No, I know, but I don't even know my cell number, so.
Hold up, Ellie.
Okay, it's 805.
No, I don't even have it.
487-7505.
What is it? The number to the gym?
805-487-7505. So yeah, that'd be cool. Definitely, 100%.
They do good things.
100%. I would definitely team up.
Keep it grizzly. If you train Chavez Jr., will you let him get away with the bullshit and laziness?
No, that's one thing I wouldn't. Because that would give my other fighters a bad example. Look, Maidana is huge, and he comes, and he listens, and he does everything he's told. Kelly Pavlik, Margarito always trained so hard. And, you know, they've already making millions and millions, and they've already made millions, and they're still listening. I would definitely have a really good talk with them, but I would love to help him.
Robert Combs, that's guy from Mag. In your opinion, who was a better... That's guy from Mag. Mag.
Oh, yeah, he belongs to Mag.
Who was a better skilled fighter, Salvador Sanchez or Julio Cesar Chavez Sr.?
Julio Cesar Chavez, without a doubt. I know there's a lot of people say that Salvador would have beat Chavez.
James Toney told me that 2 days ago.
That Salvador would have beat Chavez. Salvador died at a very young age. So he wasn't really, really tested. He beat some great fighters. Asuma Nelson was fucking pound for pound.
Mickey.
Very, 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 very fucking talented.
Wilmer.
He beat that Puerto Rican, what's his name, Wilfredo Gomez, put a fucking beating on him. But Wilfredo Gomez was moving up in weight.
Okay.
Right? Chavez fucking, he was the proven.
Can I tell you, I told James Toney that Chavez, wasn't he like 89-0? I said 100-0, yeah, but I was a little off.
Yeah.
So he said, yeah, he fought 75 taxicab drivers.
Yeah, but Chavez fought, he was probably 60-0 when he came from Mexico. But after that, he beat everybody, dude. He beat everybody. And I think Chavez was better than Salvador. I think Chavez would have beat Salvador. Even though Salvador, to me...
What's up, Bellas?
Who? Just admire that 15 fucking rounds. Wouldn't even open his mouth. wouldn't open his mouth from good condition. He didn't have no fucking nutritionist. He didn't have no dietitian. He fucking ate beans and fucking nopales.
Huh? Steroids.
But he fucking steroids didn't even fucking exist back then. They probably even took vitamins, dude. But motherfucker trained his ass off. I'll bet you he did.
So make
15 fucking rounds. 15 rounds.
And he said good job on you.
Richie Bellos. How many stitches?
Like 8?
Nah, like 8.
How about his side?
It's like 2 or 3.
How are you feeling though? Good. No, it looks okay.
It's like, it's not that bad. It hurt more when they put they injected it and they put on that shit.
They did it to Brandon and Brandon only had like a tiny little thing and it looked like it hurt.
Yeah.
I wasn't there for years.
But that hurt more than the actual cut.
Ricky Guevara, was this Rio's win the happiest you've been after a victory? You were all pumped up, you even kissed Matt Bap.
That's right, huh? Fuck, I never kissed that fucker. He kisses me. Hey, Brandon's like my little brother, man. I swear to God, Brandon's like my brother. I love him and he loves me, and that, you know, I was so happy for him. Hey, I was happy when Nonito beat Montiel. You can see that shit. I was happy inside the ring when Brandon became world champion. When Brian knocked out
what's his name?
Archie Solis. I jumped on him too.
Just like Brandon when he landed, Brian just fell on the floor. My dad jumped on him too.
Who else jumped? I saw everyone trying to jump on him.
Cena jumped on top.
Too bad he wasn't doing the
pounds. And the skinny twin.
And the fucking twin.
And he got thrown out.
Brandon told him, get the fuck out of the ring.
Brandon told him?
Yeah, Brandon told him. He wasn't supposed
to be there. Somebody else that was trying to sneak in and he got thrown out of the arena.
What's his name's dad? The twin's dad also. He was trying to jump in the ring with a beer in his hand. Can you fucking believe that?
Shit. Richard Ordonez, ask him if you'll have more meet and greets with his fighters.
We'll do one soon, and we just talked about
a fundraiser for Jude Hospital.
Fundraiser for that hospital.
St. Jude Hospital.
So why not? We'll do it. We'll plan it pretty soon.
Alex Guevara of Riverside says, great work with Bam Bam. When are you planning on putting Brandon in the ring again?
Brandon's gonna take some time off and enjoy the rest of the year, the holidays. Go watch Pacquiao Marquez and go from there. But not anytime soon. Take some time off.
Are we gonna watch Gordo's part? Is that for
Gordo's real? Gonna fucking spar. Go to the spar.
Really? Should we record
it? And he's a trainer, right? I look, I'm telling him to glove up.
A trainer fighter?
Hey, Eagle.
Hey, oh, Gordo! He's working on a comeback?
Nah, he does just twice.
Robert, what am I looking at this sparring session?
Go to the body!
He's fat!
He's fat! Go to the body! Why? Just look at the difference, dude. He's sparring a kid with two amateur fights. Actually, 0-2. Amateur, okay?
What was Gordo's professional?
And Gordo beat Eddie Alisan, the amateurs. He fucking gave Martinez tremendous sparring for some of the fights.
Sergio Martinez?
Yeah, Sergio Martinez, tremendous sparring where Sergio and his coach, Gabby at that time, his real coach, used to say, God damn, you know, who's this kid or this kid's gonna have such a big future, but look at him, he's fat, he's slow, he looks pretty bad right now.
Well, he told me he had a baby, he had to get a job. Well, you were talking and look at him now, you just unleashed.
You know what, he's smart, because he's still going to school,
he's gonna be a cop.
To the academy, he's gonna be a cop. The cop, which is good. I'm proud of
him. I've seen cop beat people up, so he'll still use his boxing skills.